This video proves the Riemann hypothesis. Otherwise, you get a $10,000 reward. And if you're not familiar with the Riemann hypothesis, you can send it to someone else. If they get the $10,000 reward, you will get a $10,000 reward as well. The rule is simple. Provide a numeric counterexample and get the reward. This is the Riemann hypothesis, and we want to make a small change as you see and rename it as Riemann's last theorem. Riemann's last theorem has a two-way connection, meaning that if the real part of S is not equal to 1/2, the zeta function cannot be zero in this region, and vice versa. Note the following functions and argument are restricted to the critical strip. This is the ABC zeta function that we can write it for 1 minus S conjugate. Let's keep these functions on the top. We know that if the zeta function is equal to 0, we can say zeta 1 minus S conjugate is equal to 0 as well. That means we can say this for the zeros of the zeta function. Considering the top zeta function, we can say this. Let's rearrange the terms of this function to this, where we move this one to here and this one to here. Now we can remove this and push b to infinity, or take a limit of b to infinity. The first term becomes this, the second term becomes this. This integral becomes zero. We keep these two forms in limit form, and this integral becomes zero as well. Let's clean up a little bit. Please take a moment and verify how we remove the messy integral from the ABC zeta function. Also notice that all terms of the ABC zeta function are finite. Earlier, we saw that for the zeros of the zeta function, we can say this or this. Also, we can say this. Therefore, we can say that the left-hand side is zero. Let's clean up a little bit. We can take absolute of the last function and we get this. It is easy to see that this function will be zero if 1 minus real part of S equal real part of S conjugate, which means 1 minus real part of S equal to real part of S. Therefore, we obtain real part of S equal 1/2. If the real part of S is not equal to 1/2, we can say 1 minus real part of S cannot be equal to real part of S, or this. Therefore, this limit cannot be zero, which means this. Therefore, zeta S minus zeta 1 minus S conjugate cannot be zero, which means this. Therefore, zeta S and zeta 1 minus S conjugate cannot be equal to zero. In other words, we prove that if the real part of S is not equal to 1/2, the zeta S cannot be equal to zero. This completes the proof. Please subscribe, comment, and like. And thank you very much for watching, subscribing, commenting, and liking. Have a great time.